Welcome to Electrical Storehouse. In this video, we are going to discuss about Power System Second MCQs, which is based on load flow analysis. So basically, load flow or power flow analysis is the determination of current, voltage, active power, reactive power at various points in a power system operating under normal steady state condition. Okay, so let's get started. First question is, which among the following quantities are to be determined in voltage controlled bus? P and Q, Q and V, V and L, Q and L. So correct answer is Q and L. Look, there are three type of buses: load bus or PQ bus, generator bus or PV bus, slack bus or reference or swing bus. In load bus, active and reactive power are specified and voltage magnitude and load angle are not specified. Generator bus, active power and voltage magnitude are specified and reactive power and load angle are not specified. In slack bus, voltage and load angle are specified. Okay, second question is, which among these quantities are to be determined in slack bus? Options are P and Q, Q and V, V and L, Q and L. Correct option is P and Q. Next question is, which among the following buses constitute the maximum number in a power system? Options are slack bus, PQ bus, PV bus, and all of these. So correct answer is PQ bus. Okay. Next question is, what percentage of buses in the power system are generator buses? Options are 5%, 25%, 70% and 10%. So correct answer is 10%. Why are load flow studies carried out? Options are to study of stability of the system, for fault calculations, for planning the power system and all of these. So correct answer is for planning the power system. Basically, load flow studies are made to plan the best operation and control of the existing system, as well as to plan the future expansion to keep with the load growth. Okay. Next question is, the voltage of particular bus can be controlled by controlling the, and options are reactive power of the bus, active power of the bus, phase angle and reactive power. So correct answer is reactive power of the bus. Next question is, which one of the following matrix reveals the topology of the power system network? And options are primitive impedance matrix, bus impedance matrix, primitive admittance matrix and bus incident matrix. So correct answer is bus incident matrix. Next question is, the bus admittance matrix of power system with respect to diagonal has, and options are one only value symmetry, both position and value symmetry, only position symmetry, complete symmetry. So correct answer is both position and value symmetry. Okay. Next question is, compared to Gauss-Seidel method, Newton-Raphson method takes, and options are less number of iteration and more time per iteration, less number of iteration and less time per iteration, more number of iteration and more time per iteration, more number of iteration and less time per iteration. So correct answer is less number of iteration and more time per iteration. Now firstly, take a look difference between Gauss-Seidel method and Newton-Raphson method. So first difference is, Gauss-Seidel method, load flow equations are non-linear in rectangular coordinates. In Newton-Raphson method, load flow equations are non-linear in polar coordinates. Okay. Second difference is, Gauss-Seidel method, it has linear convergence characteristic, and Newton-Raphson method, it has quadratic convergence characteristic. Gauss-Seidel method, less memory requirement, and Newton-Raphson method is more memory requirement. Next, computation time per iteration is less in Gauss-Seidel method. Gauss-Seidel method, computation time per iteration is less, and Newton-Raphson method, computation time per iteration is more. Okay. Next, Gauss-Seidel method, require large number of iteration to reach convergence, and Newton-Raphson method, require a smaller number of iteration to reach convergence. Next, टोटल टाइम टेकन टू गेट कन्वर्जेंस इज हाई इन गॉस सीडल मैथड एंड न्यूटन रैप्शन मैथड टोटल टाइम टेकन टू गेट कन्वर्जेंस इज लेस. गॉस सीडल मैथड द नंबर ऑफ इटरेशन रिक्वायर्ड टू गेट फॉर कन्वर्जेंस इंक्रीजेज विथ साइज ऑफ द सिस्टम दैट इज नंबर ऑफ बसेस एंड न्यूटन रैप्शन मैथड द नंबर ऑफ इटरेशन इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द साइज ऑफ द सिस्टम. नेक्स्ट इन गॉस सीडल मैथड as the selection of slack bus is changed the convergent criteria also will change and newton raphson method the convergent criteria is independent of the selection of slack bus. Next unreliable convergent less accurate and used for smaller system in gauss seidel method and newton raphson method reliable convergent more accurate it can be used for larger power system. Okay, this is the basic difference of Gauss Seidel method and Newton-Raphson method. Now next question is, which of the following simultaneous equation is being involved in load flow studies? Options are non-linear algebraic, linear differential, linear algebraic, non-linear differential. So correct answer is non-linear algebraic. Next question is, the slack bus has to be. Options are generator bus, load bus, generator or load bus, neither generator nor load bus. So correct answer is generator bus. Okay. Next question is Gauss Seidel iterative method for solving the and options are both linear and non-linear algebraic equations, both linear and non-linear differential equation, solving differential equation and solving algebraic equations. And the correct answer is both linear and non-linear algebraic equations. Next question is normally Z bus matrix is a and options are null matrix, sparse matrix, full matrix and unit matrix. So correct answer is full matrix. In Z bus matrix all elements are non-zero so more memory is required. Okay. Next question is for n bus power system size of Y bus matrix is options are n minus 1 into n minus 1, n minus 2 into n minus 2, n into n, n minus 1 into n minus 2. So correct answer is n into n. Next question is, which of the following matrix is used for load flow studies? Options are Y bus matrix, Z bus matrix, unit matrix and null matrix. So correct answer is Y bus matrix. Y bus matrix also known as sparse matrix. In this matrix, most of element are zero. That's why less memory is required. Next question is the speed of fast decoupled load flow method when compared to the Newton-Raphson method is approximate. Options are 5 times slower as compared to Newton-Raphson method, speed per iteration same, 2 times faster NR method speed per iteration, 5 times faster the NR method speed per iteration. So correct answer is 5 times faster the NR method speed per iteration. Next question is the dimension of the bus incidence matrix is options are so correct answer is E into N minus 1.